Hello guys, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to be doing a bit of a, I guess you could say my fishing tackle review, but I'm also just going to be helping you get started into fishing. Let's get on with it. Alright, so first of all, you're probably thinking, Jack, what kind of fishing pole should I start out with? Well, if you were a new beginner, really haven't gone fishing much, you don't know much about it, but you know you like it enough to want to buy more gear, I would start out with one of these. This is the Shakespeare Reverb Rod and Reel Combo. It's a 5 foot, 6 inches, medium action rod, and it comes stock with 6 to 12 pound line. So for starters on this thing, you've got your, right up here, you've got your drag system, you've got your bail to cast and whatnot. You've obviously got all the eyes, since they have all the eyes, you've got your rod, and then you've got stuff. So to cast this thing, all I have on here is, this is just a little topwater popper, really awesome bait. Almost caught a fish on this, but really cool, by Ozark Trail. All you do is, so you put your finger on the string, just like that, when it's right about here, turn your spool till it's here, put your finger down on like this, your index finger with the line right there, just like that, open up the bail, and then just cast it. And then once you get to your designated spot, you just flip it back. It is very, very, very simple, and doesn't require a lot of skill at all. But like I said, put your index finger on this, flip open the bail, and then just cast it out. And stop it once it gets to its designated spot. And whenever it hits the water, just kind of go tap, tap, tap. But, here's a topwater popper. It's super cheap. I think it for like $3, I think. Maybe even less. But, that's the spinning combo. Really sweet deal. Only $15 at Walmart. I love this thing. It's super durable. I very much recommend it. And, comment down below what kind of fishing pole you have, because I would love to know. Comment down below if any of you have loose fishing gear, because I think that's cool. But I know you all are super nice. Yeah, I was expecting to get really, really, really nasty comments, and I'd expect them to get totally grilled because of the quality of my videos. But alright, so you've been using a spinning combo for a couple of years. You're kind of bored of it. I mean, you know there's upgrades out there. I'm going to show you the upgrades. This right here is a bait caster. Now, if you want to learn a lot about bait casters and how to stop backlash and whatnot, there's other videos on YouTube about that. This is just a kind of in-depth, a little bit more in-depth than most of my videos. But all I have tied on here is I got this at Ollie's for like $5. This is the Berkeley Bad Shad 7. It's kind of in a weird, like, orange and black stripe color. And the line I have on here is also from Ollie's, but the line is by Lake and Stream Fishing Tackle, and it's 20 pounds. Clear blue. Looks super sick. Looks pretty natural, if you ask me. And, this is just a really good combo. This is a really light lure. It's only probably half an ounce or so. It's really light, not the best for a bait caster, because a bait caster is meant for heavier lures, because let me tell you about a thing called backlash. Backlash is whenever your line and lure, or no, backlash is whenever your spool of line is going faster than your line and lure, and that just causes it to frill up, because this can't catch up to that, because it's not going very fast. The lighter the lure you have on there, the worse the backlash will be if you're not good at stopping it. There are, on a lot of bait casters, there's a lot of, you know, gears, bearings, brakes.
Look behind you!
Okay, there's a squirrel behind me.
Hello.
But, basically, you got all these gears and these brakes and these spool tension knobs. Which, my spool tension knob is off because I don't need it anymore, because I'm good at stopping backlash, but some of them them have that, and it really helps to stop the backlash. But your most important break out of all of them is this right here, your thumb. Whenever you press this button right here, and you stop it, that is breaking it. So I'm gonna do a cast. I'm gonna put my thumb right on the button. I'm gonna stop the spool for a second. As I cast, I'm gonna put pressure on the spool, allowing it to slow down. And then I stop it once it hits my designated spot. Cast it out there. Now, I've gotten really good about stopping backlash, but... Oh, that's nice. It's really cool. Just press the button, thumb it, and then... stop it once it gets to the designated spot. You want to apply very little pressure, but once it starts to frill up, you just want to put it all the way down. What will happen sometimes is it'll backlash, but as it goes even farther, it'll just unbacklash itself, which is pretty helpful, but sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you're going to get a nasty backlash up, but this is a reasonably easy bait to use, and I got 20-pound line on here, so. I have some friends that are probably watching this right now, and they know what a bait caster is and all that, spinning combo. They love fishing. And, you there in the crowd, you know who I'm talking to. But, I have a friend who's a big fisherman too, and he's moving pretty soon. I mean, he's one, but he likes it just as much as I do. And his dad owns some bait casters, and they're super cool. And I got my phone. But as you can see, it's kind of clear blue line. Super cool fishing pole. I love this. There's more videos on this if you really, really need to know. But I got this online at Amazon for only $30, when bait casters can get really expensive. Oof. But this little crankbait on there, nothing special. But yeah, I love this bait. It's super cool looking. Shit. But yeah. If this helped you at all, please do tell me. Comment section down below. Like this video. Do not forget to subscribe, because if you're not subscribing, then what are you even doing, man? Like, come on, man. And, comment down below what I should do next, because it's the month of June. A lot can happen. And in the near future, I'm just on the verge of telling y'all. It's going to be very soon. If it actually happens. I don't want to excite you guys, but there could be something extremely cool happening very soon that will help my channel so much. And I'm just on the verge of telling you. Once it's said and done, and we'll actually know what's happening, then I'll tell you. And there's a squirrel over there, by the way. So that's going to wrap up this video. If you have any more questions, I will definitely make more videos on this, obviously. I'm Outdoor Jack. Thank you all for your support. It's greatly appreciated. You have no idea. Other than that, I didn't expect anybody to like this channel, because I thought it was crap myself, but you guys are being awesome about it. Thank you all for watching this video. Like I said, please comment down below. If you're ever gone fishing, what is your PB bass? Like this video, turn on the bell, post notifications, like the video, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.